We're not in Barra, but nevertheless, we'll just have to pretend we are. Times is hard in Barra, you'd hear the buttocks cry. No food to feed the sparra, and every bottle dry. Old men once fresh and frisky and full of ploy and play, drop dead for want of whiskey, the blessed whiskey bear. Oh, the dusty dry Sahara is a bare and barren land, but the drought that year in Barra was more than man could stand. Life was hard and cruel, and the days were long and sad, when the strongest drink was gruel, and the war was going bad. A clever man, old Hector, and wise the words he said, without the barley's nectar, a man is better dead. But strange the ways of heaven, when men in darkness grope. Each sorrow has its leaven, each tragedy its hope. The great ship politician, her hold stocked high with grog, steamed proudly past the island and foundered in the fog. One kiss was rent asunder, 12 bottles came to grief, as the Barra surf like thunder came pounding on the reef. Then the scent of nectar came on the wind's wild breath. I smell it, screamed old Hector. It's whiskey, sure as death. He yelled, Kirsty, Kirsty, bring down my oilskin coat. No more will we be thirsty. Salvation's on that boat. And though first her tongue had blistered, old Kirsty forced a laugh. I'm coming too, she whispered. It's me that needs a half. Now, John McNeil was dying, the death that's far the worst. No end so sad and trying as the fatal pangs of thirst. For weeks he had been lying without a sign of life, and all the neighbours crying for his nearly widowed wife. He sobbed, I am delivered from torture, I am free. And his nostrils flared and quivered in the glory from the sea. He shook just like an aspen. The man, he thought, was dead. And gulping, sighing, gasping, he vaulted out of bed. Barefooted in his nightie, he slipped from out the reach, and with steps both long and mighty, he headed for the beach. Now, Sarah Jane McKinnon, a lady through and through, was just a wee bit partial to a drop of Mountain Dew. She sat beside the ingle, her form all old and bent, when her blood began to tingle at a well-remembered scent. One sniff and she was rising, two sniffs and straight outside where odours appetising were blowing from the tide. By Jove, she went full throttle across the Barra turf when she heard a tinkling bottle in the thunder of the surf. She ran, but so did others, hundreds, maybe more, as uncles, cousins, brothers stampeded for the shore. The boats went gaily dashing across the crested wave, the long oars dipping, splashing. There the lad in the cave. They climbed aboard the liner, the hawk, the lame, the old. No Vikings were ever finer, no pirates half so bold. They peered with anxious faces inside the gaping hold and saw 1,000 cases of precious liquid gold. A shame, said Kirsty, it is an act of God. Just think of Barra thirsty and all this going abroad. Och, the keelies, och, the pleasures, och, the joys in Castle Bay, as the gurgling golden treasure chased the cares of war away. Och, the bottles that were hidden deep beneath the croft, och, the kisses in the midden, and the joy up in the loft. Who would heed an airied warning? Who would hide himself in fright with a tumbler in the morning and a bumper late at night? And for boys, Barra boys hard fighting on sea and ocean wide, deserve a wee bit partial with glook 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 inside. All Hector cried when winning, the fact is plain to see, this night is the beginning of victory at sea. he swigged and another jugful, and happily he sighed. The Yarramaltich have had it now, barrers fortified. As long you know for Churchill, his name I proudly call, but the Borough politician is the grandest of them all. Yay!